Hello and good morning. Jim Pettibone again. We're getting down to the very final, well, two last cities. San Diego and El Centro. So, we're taking a load of frozen food from Barstow to San Diego. We got a little over 10 hours remaining on the contract. And standard earn just a little, very little over $2,500. We're driving the Scott A2HD Daycab. 450 horsepower. 1,350 foot-pounds of torque. Not a clue. Alright, so anyway, let's drive. Okay, so it's now I'll have to take it from this side. Let's turn on our parking lights. Okay, and take our picture. And let's hop in the cab. I can't make the steering wheel vibrate like that. Okay, let's see, get ourselves comfortable here. Set the parking brake and turn on the engine. It's not quite 4 o'clock in the morning, expected delivery a little after 9 in the morning. 202 miles. Okay, put in gear. Move the foot pedals. This is a kind of a, I don't know, seems like a little long trailer. Oh, that's cute. Appears to be this truck shift point's about 2,000 RPM. Yeah, when I checked, I was looking for loads for either San Diego or El Centro. There was nothing for El Centro. And when I do make the El Centro run, I have to make it across the... Oh, shooting star. I haven't seen one of those in a long time. I haven't seen a clear night sky in a long time. I haven't seen you. Wasn't even actually looking in the mirror when I pulled it. Come on. It's gonna be forever. Not necessarily. I like this. I like this nighttime. I like that you can see the lights of the cars just way off out there. Oh, Jack in the Box. I see the Jack in the Box sign. I don't see... cruise by here a little slower. Jack in the Box and Rite Aid. And big a lot. Trick. So when I go to El Centro, I've got to come in from the Arizona side. That'll give me my Powell journey or Powell expedition. From Steam Achievements. Come on. Slow down. Slow down. Speed up. Slow down. While I'm sitting here, I just realized, I just remembered. Let's see, San Diego. Okay, yeah, we made a little alteration there, so we go by those two undiscovered things. We got off I-5 early. Where are we? Okay, oh, we don't have to worry about any scales. Oh, here, catch the I-5 and head south. I've yet to see the Hollywood or the World Truck sign or whatever. Because I know somebody had a mod out there to change the World of Trucks to Hollywood. Most of it's because I'm not really sure where I'm supposed to be looking. Well, oh no, you don't. Thank you. What an experiment here. I drove a truck and trailer and Euro truck last night. And when I did this, well, that trailer just rocked back and forth. Alright, let's set our cruise control. So I think I don't know, thinking about starting a new series or whatever, just Southwestern Trucking. Not sure. Really sure yet, because after I make these two cities and the one achievement, at that point I've done everything I intended to do in this series. And I suppose let's go into the career mode. I should start driving my own truck and be responsible for stuff. And I think on that, I'll have I have 9 different trucks. This Scott Daycab, the Freightliner Coronado, the Freightliner Cascadia, the Freightliner FLB, the Kenworth. Cab over, and of course the 3 trucks in the game, and then the Freightliner Argosy, and the Volvo. Forgot about that one. I think what I'm going to do is I'll buy the cheapest truck. I have $120,000. We're still going to buy the cheapest truck, which I think is the Freightliner Coronado, and drive that for like 10 runs. Get the next cheapest truck and drive that for maybe 10-15 runs. Well, it depends on how much, you know, how much money I'm making. Expand my garage, pick up a couple other as I come on. There we go. Expand my garage, and after I'm done driving the Coronado, just take it, turn that over to a driver. After I drive this truck, San Diego Discovered, stick that in the garage, and turn it over to a driver, and whatever the next inexpensive on this big main street. I can't go either way. What's the deal? What's that? So I guess that's what my plans are, but now I don't know whether to run it as, you know, American Truck Simulator episode 395, something to somewhere, or run it as Southwestern Trucking. I think that's what my company name is. I don't know, maybe I'll blend the two of them together. Oh, recruitment agency. just not sure what to do. I guess probably be better just to keep running them as the American Truck Simulator. There's a big place down here on the right. Peterbilt. Skateboard park out in front of Peterbilt. Oh, we got a turn here. Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. That was close. Well, that's right. I delivered here lots of times before. It wasn't until I was watching Corrales doing one of his runs that I realized that the San Diego Zoo like three or four deliveries to this place, and it wasn't until I was watching Corrales drive that it came around here. And there's the San Diego Zoo. And a huge parking area you can't get into. Where do you need it? There, there. Well, I'll probably do it there. Are we already up against the wall back there? Oh, hell yes. Huh. Well, let's see. Shut up! Here we go. jumped into this a little quicker than I anticipated, but... Okay, four-way flushers. Put in reverse. Okay. Again, I don't talk a whole lot while I'm backing up. It's taking too much of my concentration. Okay, they'll take it. We'll take it. There we are. Take it out of gear. Set the parking brake. Oh, stop it. And decouple our trailer. And there we are. Excellent job. 217 miles, 6 hours, 23 minutes, 45.9 gallons of fuel, $2,504. 215 experience points. So, there we are. Another job under the belt. If you like what you're seeing, remember to press that thumbs up. If you want to continue following my journeys across the southwestern states, subscribe. Comments are greatly welcomed. And thank you for watching, and that's the end of this video for today.